are being designed by solving these examples. And we have a set of examples we will go over, and I will show you the different ideas for each example. For this one, you have 5-inch reinforced concrete slab shown in the figure, is to be supported with steel W sections 8 foot on centers. Yeah, it's been asked, there's some people they think this is the span. It's not the span. Each 8 feet there is a floor beam. Yeah, this is a floor beam, this is a floor beam. This is the span of the floor beam. The span. 20 feet. This is the spacing between each beam. Yeah, each beam has a tributary width. It's a tributary width with the next beam 8 feet. Okay? And the thickness of the slab is 5 inches. For the self weight, and when you calculate the self weight, the slab is 5 inch. The beams with a span 20 are assumed to be simply supported. The beams are simply supported. If the concrete slab is designed to support a live load, the live load is 100 PSF, 100 pounds per square foot, or 0.1 KSF, kick per square foot. Steel section required to support the slab, designed the lightest steel section. It is assumed that the compression flange of the beam will be fully supported laterally by the concrete slab. The concrete weighs 150 pounds per cubic foot, halfway to 50. And 150 self weight of the concrete in the pound system, 150 pounds per cubic foot. So if you take 1 cubic foot, 1 foot, by 1 foot, by 1 foot, you put it on the scale, 150 pounds. 150 pounds. Good? Now, so if the slab, we need to find the unit weight of the slab per feet square. The kul feet square. We have 5 inch. If the slab was 1 foot, and 1 foot how many inch? 12. Dozen. 12. Yeah, can think of 1 foot, what's the unit weight of the slab?
100.
What's the weight of the slab per square feet? 150 pounds per square feet. 150 times 1. But the thickness of the slab is 5 inch. Yani 5 over 12 feet. 5 over 12. So 150 times 5 over 12, that's the weight of the slab per square feet. Okay? Yani you can add 6 inch. What's the 175 PSF. That's the self weight. And there is no additional self weight. Sometimes when you do the senior design of the project, you assume there is tile, there is mechanical loading, there is all the additional lead load. But in this case, he's not asking you about the additional lead load. It's just the slab. Just the slab. Good? So the self weight will be 5 over 12 times 150. That's in pound per square feet, which is PSF. This is PSF, pound per square foot. Okay? Then you have the lead load and live load. Per square feet. So when you design the member, when you design the beam, the supplement beam, this W is per square feet or per feet?
Per
feet of the length of the member. Yani كل feet من length. Per feet or per foot of the length of the member. So we calculated the dead load and live load per square feet. So each one is in charge of a width of 8 feet. The نص البحر هاي the نص هاي. Half to the distance between this and the other floor beam, W thing, and half the distance between to the other floor beam. يعني ممكن تقول هاي 8 وهاي 6. فبصير من هون 4 ومن هون 3. 4 and 3. In this case, 8 and 8. So the width is, the beam is in charge of carrying or supporting a width of 4 plus 4, which is 8. So the weight per foot of the beam will be 8 times the load per square feet. Good? That's how you calculate the weight per foot. Once you have that, you do W square over 8 after you magnify the foot. That's the design moment. That's an ultimate. You go find a section to support this thing. Good? Now look, this statement is important. هاي مهمة. In the question, it is assumed that the compression flange of the beam will be fully supported by the. What does this mean?
Not washing it.
No flexural torsional bucket. Good? He says no flexural. Or you can say the beam will develop
empty.
Okay. So, or the design strength of this beam will be phi and p. Yeah, phi and p. Yeah, you need to calculate beam with we select اختار beam with في ام بي greater or equal ام ultimate. Good. This is the calculation. Self weight 5 over 12 times 150 divided times 8 the critical width. Okay, so you get 0.5 kick per foot. Live load is 100 times 8, that's 800 pounds per foot, which is 0.8 kick per foot. So the factor load will be 1.2 dead plus 1.65, you get 1.8 kick per foot. Simply supported beam, W square over 8, 1.88 times 20 square over 8, you get 94 foot kick. Now select a beam with phi and b greater than this, that's your design. That's your design. So z required, the minimum z, is m over phi f1. If you want to select by z, then you can select by z or you can select by the charts. You can select by the charts. Equal 94 over this. You need z more than this. You need z more than this. He's saying this section here has z equal 26. Yeah, you need 25, you get z equal 26. So he's saying we will divide this section and then within by 25. Okay? Self weight of this one. Why is assuming 0.44? Should be, is it 10 by 44 or 22? If this is 22, it should be 22. If this is a mistake. This one assume 22. So you calculate the additional moment due to self weight. Additional moment will be 1.9, sorry, the factor load after you consider the self weight will be 1.9, so the moment will be 95. Z required is 25.4, you're still good.
Let me show you
one. And once you select the section, you add the airborne weight, you calculate new arm ultimate, and you check is the Z required selected good or not. Yeah. Here, without the self weight, it's a Z 25. We selected a Z of 26. Now we included the self weight. You know the beam. You include the self weight. You require a Z, if you include the self weight, 25.4, your section is good. Now, if this one was more than 26, you select a higher section.
What weight and beam? Not about ring and beam.
No, it's not that worry, 22. Hey. You select this section. Once you design, you have it. Sometimes it's nice if you want to shoot from the beginning, you can. بس if you wanna shoot from the beginning بيكون عندك sense يعني والله إذا كان اللود هيك أو هيك أتوقع القيمة تكون بالخمسين يعني دبليو يشيل بالخمسين يمكن أشوف 50 yes pound effort or 100 إذا لو too much load will level beam is long بس always take يعني consider that then consider that then it's a check so that will 10 by 22 equal 50. Where we get 10 by 22 okay can you turn the light on. Okay, again, for the beam design, we go to the beam section. The beam section. After the general, it's the first one. Okay, the beams. I showed you the other time. No matter how good it is. Start some information about the strength. This is how we select by Z. You go by Z, you calculate Z, then you find the Z, that will give you something more than 25. If you select that number, you do it. And have a look, this example is selecting by Z. You're selecting or designing by Z. Okay, guys? Or you can go by the section. And if you go to the W sections, the least W section he has, the least one is start by W8 for beams. Okay? And remember, our length is small, yani the length is almost zero. Yani remember, with the mode, it's full MP. Okay? So you go with W8 by 24, or 21, or 18, or 15. He's calculating for you here phi MP. So he's calculating for you phi MP for each one. So you pick the first one with phi and p greater than 94. And your first design, if you want to design by phi and p, the moment, you select one with something greater than 94. I'm ultimate in the 94. Where's I'm ultimate? 94. So if you wanna, you don't wanna select by Z, you wanna select by VMP. You know that sinus length is VMP. So if, what's the lightest 8 section? W8. What's the lightest W8? W8 None of the 8. Yes,
yeah.
You have W8 by 28. What's VMP?
102.
Is it greater than 92? Yeah. Yeah, the lightest W is W8 by 28. Good. W8 by 28 is the lightest 8. Good. You go to 10. What's the lightest 10? How about 10 by 19? 10 by 19. How much? Okay. طلع لي ورقة اللي معهم المانيوال تولي أسماك عليهم اللي معهم المانيوال بس اللي معهم مش هيكتبش. تمام؟ What's the string? 97.5. You see it? محمود. So for W10 by 19, phi MP is 97.5. Sorry, it's 81. 81. So it is, so for W10 by 22 is 97.5. Okay, you know what's 97.5? 26 times 0.9 times 50. That's 97.5. So you can select by phi MP or you can select by Z. Good? So if you go, so W10 by 22 is the lightest W10. You put it, you put it on the side, you put it in the first time. How did you get it in the first time? W12, what's the lightest W12? 22. W12 by 22 works. How much VMP? 110, 110. W14. The smallest is 14 by 22. What? Now, let's say you have W10 by 22, W14, 12 by 22, W14 by 22. Which one you select? Usually, the shallowest. Usually. Why? So you have enough space for, that ceiling and that. Or if you have no requirement, يعني فعلا مش سائر عن ال requirement, you select the stronger. The same price, the same price. نفس السعر. الحديد يا جماعة اللي بيقول لك إياه على الوزن، حط على الميزان وادفع. W14 by 22, W12 by 22, W10 by 22, the same price. Same price. But which one is easy to have, easier to handle?
That's all.
شيله أسهل. تحمل أسهل البدل. تركبه ساعة أكثر. See? يعني for constructability, if you have no requirement, if you have requirement of the constructability, definitely usually is cheaper for constructability. But if you don't care, sometimes the stronger is the better. نفس السعر واحد هذاك واحد أقوى نفس السعر. You pick the stronger. But it depends on other requirements. إذا مش معروفة عندك, you pick whatever. You say W10 by 22 or W12 by 22 or W14 or work or light. This is how we design. شوف لو تحط لي كله 10 شغال على 10 يقول لي دكتور حلي صح. Good? طيب. This is one way to design. This is one way to design if we have VMP. The normal thing is VMP. Now, you can do this as long as. Also, you can use this one if you check your LB. يعني the LB, the unbraced length of the beam, is this than L. P, the member will develop also VMP. You use the same concept. Now, if you have a member, the member length is more than LP. More than LP. You go with the charts. This is the start of the chart, the beginning of the chart. This is what you use. These are the beam design charts. Beam design charts. here. On the side here, available moment. The blue one is the LRFD. Yeah, look at the moment in cube foot. Here, the first section, you have 12,000 cube foot. That's a huge, 12,000 cube foot. Yeah, the can عندك the moment, 12,000 cube foot, oh, in the range of 7,500, 7,500 cube foot. This is the huge. These are the sections that will work. What's this one, the horizontal or the x-axis? That's LB, the embrace length. Yeah, if you have a number with embrace length 40, 40, embrace length LB 40, and it has a moment of 7,000 cube foot. 7,000 cube foot. What's the section that will work? You go, this is 40, you go up. You have this number, says W40 by 593. 593 works. How much the strength? 8,000. It works, right? Yeah, and you go with the length, the LB, you go up. The first moment, solid line, أول خط solid. Solid line, you hit, that's the lightest section. أخف section. اللي ما معه الهاي ما يكتب اسمه يا جماعة. اللي ما معه يكتب، اللي ما معه ما يكتب اسمه. Good? See it? طبعاً when I say section W40 by 593, actually, do you know what's 40? 40 inch. 40 inch. عارفين شو يعني 40 inch؟ 2.5 سم، كل انش. يعني 1 meter depth. What's the weight? 593 pound. Huge. يعني you should sense that 7,000 cube foot is too much. And you see this beam has 94 cube foot. 200 cube foot, 300 cube foot. After that, see the rhythm here, too much. Good? For any of these graphs, you see these graphs, any of them, you see there's a straight line, then there is this. See, for any of the sections, there is a straight line, then there is a reduction. Yani what's the straight line? Yani what's you see, so you mean the solid, you see the solid circle, what does it mean? That's the limit for LB. That's the limit for LB. Now, when I say, what's phi MB for W40 by 593? Should phi MB for W40 by 593? This is the section. That's MB for the section. That's phi MB for the section. Okay? And this link here, that's LB. Last. If the link, the unsupported link is this than this one here, you will develop VMP. If the link LB is greater than this link here, there will be a reduction. Good? All of these values are based on what? قطيع علامة. This is based on constant moment on the beam length. This is based on the worst case, أسوأ حال ممكن تعرض لها البيم, which is constant moment across the leg. If the moment is not constant, the beam will carry more. The beam will carry more. Right? But not more than VMP. Yeah, the maximum VMP. Yeah, the beam تبعك هون get you this beam, get you this moment here. This is for constant moment. If the moment is not constant, you need to adjust by كان تحدد العلامة على مصبوط. You need to adjust the strength by CB. The CB factor. You multiply the CB by VMM. If you get less than VMP, that's the strength. If you get more than VMP, your strength is VMP. See? Now, look. These charts now, you go. You keep going. Yeah, the range here, the range of the moment, 1,000. Yeah, this beam. Let's go for this beam. How much the range? How much the one? 94, right? So we are going in the range of 100. Yeah, you should see this one. 100 range. This is 9 here. LB, how much LB for this? 0. LB for this one is 0. Okay? So my moment is 90 here. 90, the blue one. 96 or 95, right? Right? So So you see the W10 by 22?
Shaykh Mahmoud, what's the one?
See, this is W10 by 22. See it? See it? The strength is 97. Okay. Plus, if the undress strength was, let's say, 20, yeah, I have the same gauge as for the member. This is the length from 2 to 34. So if the length was 20 of this beam, the LB was 20, can 20, LB can 20. How much this section will give you, W10 by 22, for a length of 20? You go. What is 10 by 22? Cannot be used even. Cannot be used for a strength more than 14. 10 by 22. Yeah. This is the graph for it. Cannot be used for this. Too much. The strength becomes very small. Okay, guys, this is how you use these things. So you can go by Z. You can go by VMN or VMP, or you can go by the charts. You can go by the charts. Or for beams with distributed load, you can go by something else, which is the maximum distributed load. This is maximum total uniform load. Maximum total uniform load for the section. You can go by this one. Maximum total uniform load. If you have a beam on distributed load, this one here is the maximum load. It means the W times the length. Total. W times the length. Okay? You can go by that, which is will give you the moment here for it. Then I'll take the moment about one. When you have when we have a beam with this. If you have a beam with distributed load, what does it mean? Usually. يعني beam عليه distributed load. What does it mean? Means it's a floor beam. Usually it means it's a floor beam. يعني beam, شو يعني floor beam؟ يعني حامل step مباشرة. Distributed load, كيف step؟ إذا beam حامل beam يا جماعة ما يكون عليه distributed load، يكون عليه pointer. A girder, a beam carrying beam, we call it a girder, عليه pointer. When you have distributed load, it means the beam has a slab. If the beam has a slab, it means continuously braced. It means the strength is VMP. Usually. If you have continuous beam, no. At the negative moment location, it's a compression flange from the other side. I extend this one. Good? Now, one more thing. If you go to the charts, and you are selecting a beam, okay? For any unbraced thing, W, you picked something, a dashed line, خط متقطع, dashed line, that gives you the strength, يعني section, you hit a section with a dashed line, بعطيك strength more than what you need, okay? What does it mean if you have a dashed line that will give you the same strength? It means there is another section, lighter than this section, يعني هذا section بيشتغل, بس في واحد أخف منه, with a solid line, بيشتغل, دور عليه. If you are designing and you are selecting, ولو معك ما كان فهمت شو اسوي. If you have a dashed line, it means there is a section lighter than this section. That's a section with a solid line that is lighter than this section. أخف منه. Good. When you are going
to be able to do it.
Yeah, when you want to وين احمد خزانة؟
هذا
وين احمد خزانة؟ بليز حمزة وين حمزة العمال؟
ايوه
محمد وشكوش بس احكي اسمك ارفع الله كرو بلقيس دعاء زياد معاذ علاء سوسن مهند نصري بس يا جماعه ما 13 اقسم بالله يجيب لكم امتحان سكن
بتحلم وفي حلم حلم بتحلمه هاي قسما بالله.
50 خذها تعال على المضافة عندي باقي 50 قد 13 امر الله يعني ليش تيجوا؟ يعني انتوا احسن من اللي غايب؟ لا اللي غايب احسن لا يجي من المهندس تفضل انا حاضر انت عز انك حضرتها.
Design the beam shown below. The unfactored effort is with the load. Three kip per foot. There is no load. Lateral support is provided at the end reaction.
Other beam. And the LB about 44. Or this load is live load. Take this is the example. Live load. So the factor load will be 1.6 times this one. You calculate the moment. Okay. Without considering the self weight. You go to the table, go to the chart or to the Z. You select a section that has higher spring than an ultimate, that's your section. So LB is 24. Once you select the section, you go, you add the self weight, multiply by 1.2, and ultimate due to the self weight will be WL square over 8, and you check your final section is good or not good. Okay? Good or not. For this beam, you need to check, maybe if this is a question like this, you need to check the deflection. And why we did not check the deflection for the previous beam? Why? يعني the question is check the deflection, then check the deflection. But usually that beam is composite with the slab. My slab. When you have the beam composite with the slab, the stiffness of the beam, I for the beam is I composite. You need to consider the concrete. يعني you need to transform the steel into concrete or the concrete into steel. How do you know how we transfer concrete into steel? نقسم على N. We transfer steel to concrete, not over N. تحول كونكريت الى تقسم على ان اور يو كابل سو يو دو ذس وان بيم لايك ذس باي ذا واي ذس بيم هير ذس بيم ويل نوت هاف كونستانت مومنت يعني ذا سترينث ويل بي اف 24 از مور ذان ذا ال بي ال بي 24 سو يو كالكوليت فور ذس كيس فروم ذا مانيوال اولسو فروم ذا مانيوال ات ذا اند اوف ذا مانيوال they give you for semi supported beam like this LCB is 1.14 or you calculate it 12.5 m max over 3 m here whatever 4.5 m here 3 m here you calculate CB but this case you can match it directly from the table 1.14 good so whatever mm pm mm you get for this one you adjust it by 1.14 should not be more than pm for the beam not be more than this one. We'll adjust this thing. This case, when you have a case like this, this is a girder. Usually, this is a girder. Yeah, this one is the self weight, usually. Self weight. And this one, a load from the beams, the floor beams. So we have this segment has a moment and LB. This segment has a moment. And LB. So LB for this segment is 12. So the moment here will be the same as the one. يعني M max for this segment is the same as M max here. The moment هون هي كلها هيك is the same. و M here, here or here is the same. But this length is 8 and this length is 12. Now this is the case. Usually when you have a case like this, when you have a case like this, 550 here and 524, and CD is almost 1. Going to be more than one. And CB, the minimum value for CB is 1. Yeah, we can assume, if you have a case like this, we can assume the moment is constant. So this segment needs to be designed but for M max or M ultimate 550. LB is 8, constant. CB is 1. This segment, 12, that's LB. M max, 550. CB, more than 1. A lot. You need to calculate M here, M here, and here, divided by M max, with CB. This segment, 4, M max, 520, 524, and CB more than 1, and LB is 10. So three segments need to be designed. And usually, this is the shortest, but it will control the design, because CB equal 1. This one usually will control the design.
أنا حسبت ثلاثة دكتور
يعني. Yeah, it looked like this.
segment. AB, BC, CD. I will select one section. I'm not going to select any different section. One section for the beam. Hey, length تبعها 12, 8, 10. This CB is 1.67, 1.67. Good. I'm ultimate equal this. So what you can do, I'm ultimate is this from the calculation. يعني you can divide by CB or select a section بعدين multiply by CB. So if you divide by CB, you need to design a section for this divided by CB. يعني if you design for this one later on according to this, you will multiply by the CB. From the beginning, divide by the CB and select the section from the chart. Then high charts زي ما حكيت are based on constant moment. So when you divide by CB, you make it constant moment. So 327 or 330, 550, 313. So which one control? 550. If the CB was 1111, this will control or this will control. Why? Because LB is
12. But the BC and the figure will end
up. Yeah, we assume it almost constant. Yeah, who are more than one? If you assume it one, it means you are slightly conservative, in the safe side. You took it one. Okay? Then you pick. If the question is select or check whether the section meet the local buckling criteria, we have equations for that. We can check the equations. Or you can say the section meet the local buckling criteria because it's compact section. If I think you use the equation to check if the section meet the local buckling, you use the equations for the whip and for the slab. This is for the B flange over 2 TF, and this is for the H over TW. If I ask you, again, check using the equations, you have to show me this one. If I said check the local buckling, you say the section is compact, it means it meets the local buckling criteria for the flange and the whip. One more question. Here, this is a live load. So when I tell you this concentrated load is a live load, we magnify it by 1.6. Any live load is multiplied by 1.6. So you see this is two segments. The LB for each of them is 12. And this is 12, and this is 12. And they have the same moment. And you just need to design or check one of them. This segment will have load. Well, the only thing that this question is to practice you how to calculate CB. Why? Because the moment will not be like in the case for this beam, you will not find it in the manual. which table shows the CB factors? Here, page 318. 318. See, you match the loading and you get the CB. يعني حكينا distributed load all the way. You can distribute load after the length 1.14. Here, this is W distributed. See? Where is the unbraced? Where is the one at the end? None. Best at the end. The first one. How much CB? 1.14. Shall we, Mahmoud? Okay. In case when you have this one. This one. We solved this one, right? This one. This 1.67 and one in the middle and 1.67. So you match your case. You match your case for CB based on the loading. If you don't have the case, ما عندك الكيس, you need to calculate from the equation. This is what this exam is showing you. How the exam is showing you this. The equation for CB. 12 and max, 12.5 and max, over 2.5 and quarter and half and max. 2.5 and max, the same as this M. 3 MA is a quarter, على ربع. MB in the middle, at the middle of the beam. And MC, 3 quarter. Good? Similar triangles. شوفوا مثلثات, it's not hard then. Okay? Then you calculate your CD. CD for this case, 1.37. And can you use this one? If I give you something like this, yes. If you hit the beam with distributed load and one load in the middle, CB is 1.37. It changes slightly depending on the values, but usually within this number. Okay, or calculate. If I tell you calculate CB, question,
For the following beam, calculate CB. This is how we calculate CB. اللي بعرف الشعب يروح يتعلم structure analysis. Moment diagram, moment at the maximum moment, the diagram, moment at quarter, moment at the half, the span, and moment at the end. Remember. And we are checking for this segment. For this segment, again, in the equation, M max will be here, right? And for this segment, MA will be at quarter of the 12. M half will be at 6. M 3 quarter will be at 9. This one will be here, and here, This is a segment now. This is LB. This thing is unbraced. Good? And it's symmetric. With this, I'm done with the beams. We start the beam column this Tuesday. Done. Thank you, Mohammed.